Hi everyone, my name is Arnoud.
I'm Danny, hi.
And we would like to tell you something about Contenium. Because we created an application server for Clojure. Why did we do this? Well, you can ask us this over a beer, but there's a hint on the slides. But we had a certain goal in mind. You want to run many Clojure applications, web applications, side by side, isolated from each other, in the same JVM, sharing the same Clojure runtime. So we set out to work if you could do this, and we can with some class loader magic. And we created a small library around this called Boxure. And with Boxure, you can create a box that loads your lining and dependencies, and then you can evaluate your forms in it. This is very fast because the Clojure runtime is already loaded, so a new box is almost instantaneously made. And also your forms evaluation is also very fast because there's no serialization or deserialization of all your data structures. What?
Teamwork. Yeah. And the click. This focus.
Okay. For this to work though, we had to patch Clojure a bit. For instance, the caching of multi-method dispatch values now are weak references so that the class loader can actually be cleaned up when you destroy a box. We made these patches for several Clojure versions. Better. For several Clojure versions, starting from 1.5.1, and this is only noticeable for Boxure itself, so your app doesn't really need to use this patched Clojure. Then he also added another patch to allow loading already loaded namespaces into your box, so we can share the Clojure core namespaces as well for more speed. So now that we have the this Boxure library, we created an application server around it for managing your apps. Your deployment configuration can be done. This one working? Yeah. Okay. You can use the deployment descriptor in your lining a declaration for this. You supply a start function of your app, a stop function for your app, and maybe some ring handler stuff or context path, what have you. Another part of the application server are the core systems. The core systems are like shared resources for your apps. They are component-like. The component library didn't exist bang when we started, but those are started on the application startup, and apps can use them. And every app gets its own configuration and a map of these systems. And now Danny is going to tell you something about deploying.
Yeah, so now that you've seen quickly the basics of how you create your app, here comes the fun part, which is deployment. If you have, as we said, we wanted to build an application server as a library, so you can mix and match the systems you need. Some of the systems we've already implemented are Cassandra connection pool, Elasticsearch connection, Kafka connections, some postal client for SMTP. So the point is, your application doesn't need to know all the port or the network settings, and you can provide defaults in your project CLJ or create, well, deploying using the module system, which is as well a library. You use a deployment descriptor with the path to your project, override any specific configuration, and well, the module system takes care of creating the Boxure for you, start running the start function, and if you build a ring application. We have another additional feature, which I like a lot. It's you start a new box. Well, if you want to upgrade your existing application, you just start new version. If the start is completed successfully, the ring handler is atomically swapped. So any existing request is still being processed by the previous version, and all new requests are handled by the newer one. And there's no connection loss or downtime or anything. And it's just choosing closures at them, basically. So like I said, it's a whole stack of libraries. And yeah, you can read slide. I can read it for you. It's sorry. If you, for example, want to test your Cassandra queries normally, or your SQL queries, whatever, you can require a containing system. Just start it in your test, run your tests, and done. So you don't need the application server to run unit tests in Jenkins. Another creative thing you might want to do with Containium, because everything is a library, you could create an Onyx peer that's started in the root class loader, so that's shared between all the applications, and then create some tasks and isolate the tasks from each other, and you have no conflicting dependencies, and you can even swap them if you want at runtime. So right now, I've been running it on my own servers, handling a few million HTTP requests. So it's pretty stable. I'm quite happy with it. And it's quite a big project with one project CLJ at the moment, or maybe three. So we're splitting everything into small libraries. It's designed as libraries, just not released yet. So that's the thing we're working on now. And I hope to maybe gather some interest and clean up the closure patches so we can maybe get it into closure mainline, but I guess I need your help for that. So that's next slide, one of the goals. So yeah, we just want to provide a nice application server that doesn't suck and that doesn't use a lot of XML but data structures, and well, makes deployment DevOps a little easier. Yeah. Thanks. Do we have time for questions?
Sure, we have
I got 1 minute.
Any questions? Sorry.
What's the story with Nixos and Containium? Is it easy to do this deployment? Because I generally find that quite difficult to get this.
Well, I like Nixos a lot, so I use the Nix package manager to create a package with a project CLJ, and then I hand it over to Containium, and then it starts. So it's not really tied to Nixos, but Nixos is cool, so check it out.
I guess you can't have state in a task.
Can you elaborate?
Local state.
Local state in what? So every box you start, that's it's a class loader, but within those class loader, in the context with using the closure patch, each box gets its own set of namespaces. So you can inject the closure core, or in our case, we also inject some of the Containium library namespaces already. But your app is completely separate from other apps, so they can have their own state. Does that make sense?
It does. Thanks.
Okay.
You mentioned earlier that you handled a couple of million requests by now.
Yeah, over the course of
what's
a year.
What's the time frame? Yeah.
Sorry?
What is the time frame?
Yeah, about a year or
okay.
Year and a half.
And the second question, what is the performance penalty for imposed by your patches?
I think the only penalty is at load time, because I didn't do any benchmarks, but I didn't notice any difference either, so How it works is each thread already in Java has a thread local class loader, context class loader, and we patched, or Boxer extends dynamic class loader from Clojure itself, and there we check if class or namespace needs to be loaded from the project dependencies or from the parent. So then the isolation is, there's not really much overhead except for the usual when you load the same library twice, you load it twice. Sorry? At runtime, the only cost might be if you find a namespace, you first dispatch on the context class loader. That's it. So the invoking a function, there's no overhead.
Okay, we have time for one more question. No? Okay. Thank you.